I saw a shooting star last night. I was going to wish on it, but then I realized I already have everything I could ever wish for. I have you. Hello? Are you there? You had me there for a second. Oh, I was so worried the call wouldn't go through. Not that there was any real reason to think it wouldn't. But sometimes I just can't help feeling anxious. Well, you never know. Some of that junk might turn out to be really important. Like a really great coupon for ice cream. Thank you, by the way, for taking my call. I hope it's not too much of a bother. Oh my goodness, I never even asked. I'm not interrupting anything, am I? You could use a break? More like you might collapse from exhaustion if you don't get one. I guess it's a good thing that I called. Someone's got to make sure you're taking care of yourself. You need to take time to rest and connect with the people you love. Does that make sense? Exactly. And maybe it's old-fashioned, but I'd rather send a postcard than an email. Although I'd hate to spread my germs licking a stamp. And I'd rather meet for coffee than sign into a room meeting. Aw, you think my typing is lovely? OMG, GTFO! Pretty sure that last one means, gosh, that's a friendly opinion! Anyway, I was just doing some chores and thinking of you. And then before I knew it, I was missing you. Quite a bit, if I'm honest. It's silly, I know. But can I... Can I tell you a secret? You're so good to me. I just wish I had something juicier to share in order to make it worth your while. But, okay, here goes. My secret is, sometimes I'm struck by this feeling of bone-deep loneliness. And I just don't know why. You know when you find a bruise somewhere on your body? And it's purple and it's tender, but for the life of you, you can't remember how you got it? Silly, I'm not really hurt, but you can still kiss me. I wish I could explain it better, but I barely understand it myself. Oh, maybe I just had a sad dream last night. And the feeling was left over after I woke up. That's when I remember I have you. And no matter how low I feel, all I have to do is reach out to you. And my heart will know for sure that it's the morning of a new day. Oh, you mean like the song? Yes! You and my little yellow chickies you gifted me. Oh, you make me so happy. I can't stop thinking about you and just smiling. I was sweeping the floors, wondering when you last swept. Or if I should bring my broom by your place. And then later, I was weeding the garden and trying to guess your favorite way to make potatoes. In that case, just don't lick them. I'd be absolutely inconsolable if you were injured in an electrified potato incident. I'm not sure I could even get through brushing my teeth in the morning without wondering. Are you out there somewhere brushing your teeth too? I sure hope so, because I can't bear the thought of you getting cavities. Maybe this is counterintuitive and I shouldn't say it. But your mouth is always in prime smooching condition to me. Oh, I really do feel so much better now. Thank you. You're the best. Truly. Among other things, I'm constantly amazed that you can lead such a busy life and still have time for little me. Now, you know I believe in the importance of work-life balance. Oh, goodness, though, listen to me. Where are my manners? I've told you all about my day, all about how I'm feeling. But I never thought to ask you about your day. That's good, because you sure have heard a lot. So tell me, how are you doing? What are you up to? How's your day going so far? What's on your mind? Oops! I guess I got a little carried away there, didn't I? I swear, I'm not usually this flighty on the phone. And I guess I'm just that excited to be talking to you. Now I know how my chickies feel when I come into the hen house. And they all start hopping up and down like crazy and peep peep peeping! Oh, I do love those adorable little fuzzballs. Aw, you're making me blush. You're such a little flirt, you know that? Everything you say just charms the pants off me. Once the leaves change, even I have to wear pants sometimes. Although I have to tell you, when someone says you charmed the pants off them, they don't usually mean it literally. And I can't tell if you really don't know that, or if you're just pulling my leg. Either way, you made me laugh all over again, so thank you. This call was just what I needed. Aww, that makes it even better. I wish I didn't have to go, but I have a knitting project I'd really like to get started today. Maybe I can send you some pics of what I'm working on later? Let's talk again soon, lol. That means lots of love. Bye-bye.